The appointment of Dr. Eric Tayag as a new Health Undersecretary earning praise from a health reform advocate. Dr. Tony Lechon tells ANC Tayag will likely be an asset to the health agency, especially in the digital era. Prior to his new appointment, Tayag was the head of the agency's Knowledge Management and Information Technology Service. He's also known as the dancing doctor for promoting the agency's campaigns through dancing.
Eric has a different way of communicating and, of course, engaging the public. I mean, in the era of social media, we need a lot of, you know, innovation, perhaps a renewed spirit as well as energy. He is an expert in infectious disease, being a former president of the Philippine Society of Microbiology and Infectious Disease. An expert communications person, charming and engaging.
A teachers group urges the Philippine government to put more funds into the country's K-12 program. This is after Senator Alan Peter Cayetano suggested to either fully fund the program or suspend its implementation. The Teachers Dignity Coalition says a bigger budget for the program is needed instead of putting more confidential funds for the Education Department.
So far, wala pa namang sinasabi ang Marcos administration that this administration is actually considering the suspension of K-12 program. Ibig sabihin, tara, diretso po tayo dito. At kung hindi diretso po tayo dito, no, eh dapat popondohan po natin ito ng mabuti.
Former Justice Secretary, now Solicitor General Minardo Guevara, denies knowledge of the massive pit discovered within the premises of the new Bilibid prison. In a text message to reporters, Guevara said he was not informed of the excavation and that the Bureau of Corrections did not seek authorization. The digging allegedly started during Guevara's time under the Duterte administration. Bureau of Corrections officer in charge, Gregorio Katapang Jr., has said the excavation had no paperwork, nor was it authorized by the agency. In a TV interview, suspended Bucor Chief Gerald Bantag claimed the excavation will be turned into a deep swimming pool since he is a scuba diver. He denies it will be used as an escape tunnel. Philippine authorities rescue 9 Chinese nationals believed to be kidnapping victims. Village watchmen chanced upon the group after 2 people jumped out of a coaster while passing through Araneta Corner, Quezon Avenue in Quezon City. This incident, which happened early Wednesday morning, was caught by CCTV. Quezon City Police District Director, Police Brigadier General Nicolas Torre, says an investigation is underway and they're searching for 2 Filipinos who were said to be accompanying the group. Torre notes it's possible they are employees of a Philippine offshore gaming operator, since dozens of computers were also found inside their vehicle.